figures from لدينا هنا ايضا بعض الارقام تتعلق بدول اسيويه اخرى فالنسبه اعلى في باكستان وفي
سريلانكا This is a new kind of advantage. But the big question is how long? How long will this advantage last? Nobody knows. My own guess when people ask, I say 3 to 5 years based on nothing other than instinct. Depends on the sector, but even this could be optimistic. So the question now comes to what do we do here? Can we learn from the mistakes made elsewhere and apply those lessons meaningfully? Can we learn from each other. And I would propose that you have in the Arab media world a lot of worthwhile experiences we know little about. I don't know if they are documented. The Al Jazeera experiment or project is a very impressive project. It's imaginative, it's lively, it's informative, it's challenging, it's agenda building to the extent it goes. There must be other projects of that kind in the Arab media world, but we want to learn about it. And there is a great need, I think, to discuss, to analyze, to document, and to draw lessons from our common experiences, including the differences, the political differences, the cultural, socio-political differences, the different levels of economic development, which surely matter in this situation. I think one of the ways we can avoid mistakes made in the other media world is to learn from each other, not making too much of our differences, but working on common areas, common tendencies, which are largely positive, but include some negative tendencies as well, while not gloating over, while we don't envy the situation in the other media world, we don't have to gloat over those trends, because there's much that is admirable, estimable in those situations. I think we can all benefit from it. Some of us straddle the two media worlds. We have gone to journalism school in Western countries. We admire some of their journalism or much of their journalism, but we do not envy their media situation for the reasons that are perfectly clear. So I hope that in this discussion, as well as in future discussions, we can go fairly deeply into what is common in our situations, where there is space for growth, where there's a great deal of work to be done in cleaning up. We need to eliminate the rogue elements in our media situations, in our media. There are plenty around. Dilip Cherian has mentioned the play of unaccounted money. There's a lot to be cleaned up there. But we also need, I think, codes of practice, codes of professional conduct and practice. Institutions like the public editor or the reader's editor, that is the function of an internal news ombudsman developed in newspapers like The Guardian in the UK and also applied in the newspaper I edit has a reader's editor modeled on The Guardian's reader's editor with much the same terms of reference. I think we do have public support in many cases, but if we don't watch out and we allow the negative trends to develop and overwhelm at least major sectors of the media, we cannot possibly stop the popular or public demand for external regulation. I do not want external regulation, but there must be self-regulation, codes of practice, templates for socially responsible and ethical journalism, which are basically the same all over the world. And I think this media forum is a great opportunity for all of us, those of us who are here and those of us who read about it, to get together and really build on the best traditions of the media in the developed world as well as in our own countries. But I would love to learn much more about the Arab media experiences about which we know very little. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Well, please allow me to First of all, thank all the panel members for being here with us and giving us their perspectives on the way forward. Clearly, our session focused on Asia and India, and I think it is a great kickoff given the boom that we are seeing in that region. As much as we would like to open the for questions, I'm seeing a big sign flashing in front of me saying my time is up, and I think we run a little bit late in some of the presentations. Hope إلا أنني أرى بأن الوقت المخصص لهذه الجلسة قد انتهى وربما تستطيعون طرح أسئلتكم خلال الاستراحة في وقت لاحق خاصة وأن المتحدثين سيكونون موجودين معنا إذا كانت هذه جلسة الأولى وجلسة الافتتاح وأمل أن تكون هذه الجلسة انطلاقة رائعة لمنتدى الإعلام العربي التاسع المنعقد هنا في دبي. شكرا. Thank you.